In the meantime, I know a lot of people may be wondering, well, what exactly happens with the money?
Right.
Where does the money go and what does it do if I donate? I know that I donate $1 to the V Foundation for Cancer Research, then 100 cents of that dollar goes towards a grant. To date, $110 million have been distributed by the V Foundation. Some of that money went to the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia and their Dr. Garrett Brodeur, who received a translational grant from the V Foundation in 2010. And we are pleased to welcome the doctor to the program this morning here. Dr. Brodeur, welcome to Mike and Mike, because I think you can put a face and a voice to exactly where this money goes. Can you describe for our audience who may be considering making a donation today how that money was utilized by you and your group and the difference that it makes?
Yes, I'd be happy to. And first of all, thanks for all you're doing, and thanks for having me on the program. I can tell you that foundations like the V Foundation are critically important at this point in time because of the very low funding rate of grants at the NIH, which has been even further impacted by the sequester. So a very small percentage, maybe 5 to 10% of grants submitted to the NIH, which is the main mechanism of funding research, are actually funded. And if it weren't for foundations like the V Foundation, the pace of research would be much slower and new ideas would not be getting from the bench to the bedside. So it's critically important to have this. And it helped my lab explore a new direction of research called nanoparticle drug delivery. And this, it sounds like a difficult concept. It's actually fairly simple. Most tumors have leaky blood vessels, whereas most normal tissues have very tight junctions between the cells and the blood vessels. You can think of it as like interdigitating your fingers to the point where you could hold water and then loosening them so the water gets through. The tumor blood vessels are leaky, and we can package drugs in these nanoparticles, and they will go right by most normal tissues and get into the tumor at a much higher rate, like 5 or 10 times the rate. So by using this delivery mechanism, we can take drugs that have more or less reached the limits of what you could give, and you can give 5 or 10 times as much, or you can give the same amount and have much less toxicity that the patient would experience. So this is a new and exciting area of research that the V Foundation helped us to explore, and we now have some very exciting products that we're hoping to get to clinical trials in the next couple of years.
And doctor, this is the 20-year anniversary of the V Foundation, and we're trying to explain as best we can just how far we've come in 20 years, but I'm sure you could do it a whole lot better. You know, the last, you know, 5 to 10, all the way to the 20 years of the V Foundation, just how much all this has helped and how far you and others have gotten.
Yeah, so I would say there are a lot of progress was made with empirical approaches with the drugs we frequently use to treat cancer, which are pretty toxic. A lot of progress was made in the 70s and 80s. And then we sort of plateaued in the 90s because we weren't getting new drugs. But two things have happened that are changing the way we're treating patients with cancer, and this is children and adults. One is something called molecular profiling. It's just basically analyzing the DNA and the RNA and protein of the tumor to figure out what makes that tumor grow the way it does. So it's not just tumors in general or that type of tumor like breast cancer or neuroblastoma, but that patient's tumor. So by having the ability to analyze tumors at that level, we can maybe find the Achilles heel of the tumor. So molecular profiling, or some people call it personalized medicine, sort of using information about that patient or that patient's tumor to treat them. The second thing that's changed is targeted therapy. A lot of the drugs we used were developed empirically just because they would kill cells in culture and they would kill tumor cells a little more quickly than they would kill normal cells. But now that we have this information from the molecular profiling, we can take advantage of that to design drugs that specifically target a gene or protein or pathway that we know is critical to the survival and growth of that particular tumor. And these two concepts are the types of research that the V Foundation has been funding through this translational research mechanism.
Mike and Mike and Dr. Garrett Brodeur is with us here. He's the Audrey E. Evans Chair in Molecular Oncology, a professor of pediatrics, associate chair for research, associate director of the Abramson Cancer Center at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. That is an enormous number of things to have on a business,
business card. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
which of those do you lead with, Doc, if I may ask? Which of those would you say, if you only could have time to put one of them on a business card, would you put on there?
I would say professor of pediatrics. I mean, I'm a pediatrician first. I take care of children with cancer, but my focus is and always has been on children. So my role with the Department of Pediatrics supporting research, my role with the Cancer Center helping to develop these concepts of molecular profiling, targeted therapy, and the integration of pediatric oncology in the Cancer Center are very important, but my most important role is a professor of pediatrics in the Division of Oncology as a pediatric oncologist who not only does research but takes care of children.
If I were to pick one of those, it would be doctor.
Yeah, I would say
I'm a doctor.
Everything you just described was Golic's second career choice. He went into football instead, but that was where he was going to go. But all kidding aside, listen, cancer in all of its forms is a horrendous thing, and it's something that we all work every day to fight. But if you've ever spent any time in a children's cancer hospital, and we have, the first year that we did a Mike and Mike will come to your house to do the show, you'll remember a beautiful woman named Miranda bid on it and won it, and she wound up donating it, and we did it from a children's cancer hospital in Dallas, and we spent an entire day there on a tour. And that's an experience I'll never forget. Whenever we finish doing this show and I think back on the most memorable days we have, that will be one of them. When you have seen these kids and these families with these kids that are fighting cancer, there is nothing in the world quite exactly like it. And so, Doctor, I know you're there every day. God bless you for the work that you are doing. And so it is for people like Dr. Brodeur, these geniuses who are making a difference with this money. And I guess maybe as a final thought, Doctor, when you think about how far we've come, how excited does it make you about the possibilities of how far we can go in the next 5 or 10 years?
Frankly, I think this is the most exciting time in the years that I've been in pediatric oncology. Certainly a lot of progress was made from the time I started treating children back in the 70s, I should say. And the cure rates were more in the 30% range. Now they're in the 80% range. So we've come a long way. But we sort of, you know, hit the wall a bit. We hit this plateau, and I think the new tools we have available will make us much smarter about how to treat patients, and we'll be able to treat them more effectively and with less toxicity. And you're going to see tremendous changes in the way we treat children and adults in the next 5 to 10 years.
Well, we're doing the best we can for you today. And thank you again for the time and explaining this to our audience in ways that we obviously could not do. And thank you for the work that you do, Doctor. Thanks very much today and every day.
Well, thank you for what you're doing. If you weren't doing what you're doing, it'd be very hard for me to do my job. So God bless you guys as well and the V Foundation.
Thanks,
Dr. Garrett Brodeur in Philadelphia with us here on Mike and Mike, ESPN.